Hey there, this is René for networklessons.com and in this video you will learn about the EIGRP packets. Yeah? So we have the hello packet, update, query, reply and acknowledgement. And we'll take a look at these in detail. Yeah? The first one, the hello packet, is probably familiar, but let's look at an example. So I got two routers. Like this. And when we send hellos and we receive them, then we will try to become neighbors. Yeah? And in the hello packet, one of the things you will find is like the K values. Yeah? And the K values indicate what the metric is that you will use. Yeah? Like if you're going to use bandwidth, delay, load, reliability, or a combination of those. Yeah? So this is something that has to match on both sides before you will become neighbors. Yeah? So that's the hello message. By default, this is sent using multicast. Or if you specify the neighbor yourself, then it will be sent using unicast. Yeah? Okay, so that's the hello packet. The second one, the update. So once these routers have become neighbors, we will exchange routing information. Yeah? And this is done using the update packet. Yeah? Okay, so the first time, once we have become neighbors, we have to exchange all of our routing information. Yeah. So the first time, I'll call it full. Yeah. So the full, all the routes that we have, we exchange them using unicast. Yeah. And the next time when we have updates, so a partial update, those are sent using multicast. Okay. So the update is to exchange the actual routing information. Yeah? Okay, so there's another one, the query packet. What's the query packet for? Let me give you an example. Let's say we have a couple of routers. And let's say that this router over here, it has a topology table for EIGRP, and it has one entry for this network, 1.1.1.0/24. Yeah. This is the successor. And let's say that for whatever reason, this network disappears from the topology table. Yeah. So maybe a neighbor isn't advertising it anymore, or an interface is flapping, or whatever. Yeah. What this router will do is send a query to all of its neighbors. Yeah? And this query, basically in the query is something like, okay, I'm looking for this network. Yeah? And do you have any idea where it is? Yeah? That's what the query is for. And the second packet that you see here, the reply packet, that's what the neighbors will use. Yeah? So each neighbor has to respond with a reply packet. And it can contain two things. So let's say that, for example, this router over here, it does know where this network is. Yeah? What it will do then is send a reply. And in this reply, this is like an update message. It will contain the metric for the route that R1 is looking for. Yeah? The other option is, like, if this router really has no clue about the network that we are requesting with the query, then it will still send a reply. Yeah. But in the reply, what you will find is an infinite metric, yeah, for the network that we are querying for. Yeah? And the reason we use the infinite metric is that because R1 will then know, okay, so R3 has no clue where this route is. Yeah. So keep in mind that once you send a query, all of the routers do have to send a reply. Yeah. So either it will carry the correct metric if they know where the route is, or it will carry an infinite metric if they have no clue where the route is. So that's the query and the reply packet. The last one, the acknowledgement. Well, some of these packets are supposed to be reliable. So we expect an acknowledgement in return when we receive them. Yeah? And this applies to this one. So the update, query and reply packet. When we receive any of these packets, the router has to respond with an acknowledgement. Yeah? It's kind of like TCP. When you send some data, you expect an acknowledgement in return. Yeah? So that's basically it. These are all the EIGRP packets. I hope this video has been useful. Thanks for watching and till next time.